Hello, it's Ulysses, back for another Ask Our Experts episode. We continue answering questions about power over Ethernet. In this episode, we'll discuss the industry standards for PoE, and this leads me to our question of the day. Alan, PoE has IEEE 802.3 industry standards. However, do all PoE devices comply with these standards?
That is a great question, Ulysses. And the reason why is not all offerings in the market are compliant with the IEEE 802.3 standards. And you have to be very, very careful. There are a lot of units that say they are compatible, but they're not compliant. And what does that mean? That basically means that it does not offer many of the benefits that PoE has. The way PoE works is the device sends a signal to the source to tell it I need 90 watts of power from the source. And then the source says, okay, I know you need 90 watts of power, I'm going to turn on and deliver 90 watts of power. And once this classification handshake occurs, the chips on both sides continue to monitor to make sure there are no faults, there are no overages, there are no underage. That is what a compliant device does. A compatible device simply delivers a constant level of power at a certain level. So if it's AF, it would deliver 15.4 watts of power, but there is no protection for the end device. It doesn't turn on, it doesn't turn off. If 15.4 watts are not required, if only 7 watts are required, it's going to deliver too much. So it is extremely important to make sure that you get an IEEE 802.3 compliant device and not a compatible device.
Thank you, Alan, for clarifying that not all devices on the market comply with industry standards and why, when selecting a device, it is important to make sure it complies with established IEEE 802.3 PoE standards. Make sure to check out the links in the description below for more information about industry standards for PoE. And as always, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be the first to know when we have more insights from our experts. Bye.